This one hits close to home. A professor at the University of West Georgia has shot and killed an 18-year-old freshman student while she was sitting in her car. The reason why I say this hits close to home is because I have lectured and spoken at this very diverse institution. Let's put up the picture of the professor who was alleged to have committed this crime. His name is Richard Sigman. Richard Sigman looked like that when he was booked. Here's how he looks every day. That is Professor Sigman before he turned into a gunman, allegedly. He is a business professor and also a business consultant. Let me give you background to this extreme and heartbreaking story. A university professor shot and killed a young woman who was sitting in a parked vehicle, according to the police. Professor Richard Sigman of the University of West Georgia was arrested for a count of murder, a count of possession of a firearm during the commission of a crime, and 3 counts of aggravated assault. I'm going to explain that in a minute. Police identified the victim as the young 18-year-old Anna Jones. Here's Ms. Jones. Now, the family has a GoFundMe account set up for funeral arrangements connected to her death. They are sad, very tragic. The University of West Georgia is providing counseling services for those who need it, faculty, students, staff included. Professor Sigman allegedly got into an argument with a man at the local pizza restaurant and threatened to shoot him. He later went to a parking deck where he decided to fire into a parked vehicle, killing the occupant, Miss Anna Jones. Carrollton police on Saturday, July 30th, 2022, at approximately 12:27 a.m., officers responded to Tanner Medical Center regarding a female with a gunshot wound. Callers advised the incident occurred off Adamson Square in the courthouse parking deck. Preliminary information indicates that Professor Sigman and another male got into a verbal altercation at the pizza place. The male notified security that Sigman, the professor, threatened to shoot him. Security approached the professor, saw that he did in fact have a gun, and told the professor to exit the establishment. The professor then left walking toward the parking deck. Now, we don't know the motive. We don't know exactly why this professor decided to shoot into a parked car where a student was sitting, thus committing murder. We're not aware of these details. This story is still developing. Now, the police are saying maybe there's a motive that they are unaware of as of now. So the investigation is ongoing. Police are asking if anyone has information to contact the Carrollton Police Department at 770-834-4451. 770-834-4451. Everyone can remain anonymous. Now, I've had some conversations with students at that institution just not too long ago. I was lecturing on the campus dealing with race and diversity. The University of West Georgia happens to be a very diverse institution. Great leadership. I had a great time with the president of the college, as well as his wife, who is in academics as well. My heart and prayers are with the students, with the families that have been impacted, with the faculty and staff of this institution. I'm not sure why the professor decided to do this. I don't know why he was armed at a pizza place, but I do know that he is going to face due process. I do know he's been arrested, and now the criminal justice system will take over. And I do believe he will be held accountable for his actions. Once again, why was a gun necessary? What could have been maybe an argument, possibly a fight, transformed into a murder. All right. My dear sister, what are your thoughts on this?
First and foremost, I just cannot imagine, like, you know, being a young student, you know, going for their first year of college and, you know, dying because our America has a gun problem. The fact that she died is because, yeah, there are way too many guns on our streets. And for the people who always say, you know, we need more guns, this is what the result of more guns. The more people who have guns, the more unruly behavior that we see, the more people are gonna be using these guns to, you know, fight, you know, arguments. There was no reason why he should have even had that weapon in the first place and threatening people over something, one order, something going wrong in a pizza shop. It's completely ridiculous. And so my heart and my condolences goes out to Miss Jones's families and her friends. And again, it's just like, we need to get less, we need to get more guns off the streets. And this is again a direct result of the, you know, prevalence of gun culture in America.
Yeah, and it seems as if people believe that guns are there to either allow for an expression of anger or to make themselves come across as Billy Badass. The reality is guns should only be used in the most dire of circumstances. And when something like this happens and you have the most innocent of lives, an 18-year-old freshman student at college, she's a college student, being shot and killed by a professor at the institution, it calls into question, why do people think guns should be an everyday occurrence in the United States of America? All right.